a professional use Master of G-Series, the GPR-H1000 want to be an evolution of the best-selling triple-sensor rangeman GW9400, launched in 2013. And the best of all, best ever made, best of the best, the GPR-B1000, that was launched in 2018 with the MIP LCD display. An evolution it is, because it comes with new features, but it is not a revolution. These new features are arguably not needed in a rangeman, and let's see why. The goodies this new rangeman has, the GPR-H1000, are tracking and survival features like thermometer, pressure sensor with altimeter and barometer, compass with auto-level correction, an optical heart rate sensor, an accelerometer for step monitoring, and a gyrometer are among the fitness and health features. In addition to having a tight graph dawn and sunset timings, among data, the GPR-H1000 is outfitted with GPS for obtaining positioning data. Similar to the GPR-B1000, it has a cylindrical button structure that is shielded by gaskets, making it officially resistant to dirt and dust. If the GPR-H1000 has GPS route navigation capabilities similar to the GPR-B1000, is one of the key questions that has not been answered by numerous leaks. It doesn't. So it is useless in this context, I would say. And rather than being a continuation of the navigation-focused GPR-B1000, it is more akin to the robust survival version of the GBDH-1000 or GBDH-2000, which uses the same sensors. Or you can see this watch as a more sophisticated Madman GW9500. Despite the routes and waypoints cannot be programmed into the watch, like they could be on the GPR-B1000, the GPS on the GPR-H1000 is utilized for activity tracking and can follow routes movement on the smartphone app. Similar to the GBDH-2000, this new rangeman can use GPS to change the current time and obtain current position coordinates. I see this new rangeman model not as a pure breed, not as a pure rangeman. It is a mix, best of both worlds, between the GBD series and rangeman series. Few months ago, leaked photos were posted about the new coming rangeman, and now it is confirmed for the mid-January 2024. Rangeman philosophy is about self-sustaining, is about maximizing battery life, giving you the best possible scenario to push forward and reach safety. It's not about having colored screen and maps, because it consumes even more energy, draining the battery even faster. Lastly, when you are in the wilderness fighting for your life, little care you will do about calories burned that day, or how many steps you have made. Using smartphone app for activity tracking and route movement, it's useless in my opinion. How many days a battery on a smartphone can last? 1 day? 2 days? 3 days? What are you doing after that? So in my opinion, the rangeman needed to be a rugged, long-lasting, self-sustaining survival tool like watch. It is obvious already that Casio will expand the other lines with HR capabilities, because this falls more or less within Casio's strategy. In this case, I am confident to say equipping the rangeman with HR sensor, it is a controversial decision at best, in my opinion. Let me be clear and say it again, the entire rangeman philosophy of being is about long-lasting, self-sustaining survival tool like watch. Rangemen should and must be the last line of defense, the only item that you are sure will not let you down. When you are in the wilderness fighting for your life, little care you will do about calories burned that day or how many steps you have made. Now, let's speak about the dimensions. All of the Rangemen fans were expected the new model to be a little slimmer than the highly praised GPRB 1000, that is indeed a big watch. The new model, the H1000, measures 60.6 by 53.2 by 20.3 mm and weighs only 92 grams, which is not nor slim or light, but is better than the previous model overall. Price will be around $500, so it is not a premium model. If you ask me, I'm not impressed. I'm rather disappointed. They managed to tame the Rangemen. It is not better than this model, the GBD H1000, which is a great watch, and have full GPS capability, fitness, HR and triple sensors. And it's light years behind the best of the best G-Shock ever made, the GPRB 1000. The conclusion in just few words, I will not buy it.